Hello friends, so today I will give you some information and review regarding this particular phone. This is the Redmi Note 10s, the upgraded version of Redmi Note 10 Pro. So I have been using this phone for 1.5 months and it's working really nice. The overall features and specifications of this particular Android phone will be discussed in this video. So please watch this video till the end. So now let's come to the features. It's giving 64 megapixel AI quad camera with AMOLED display of 6.43 inches. It's a full HD AMOLED display. So it's not a super AMOLED, but it's an AMOLED. So it's really very smooth gliding over the screen. And the main thing about this processor is the MediaTek Helio G95. The MediaTek Helio G95 with MediaTek Hyper Engine is very good for gaming purpose. It gives you fast and smooth action in your favorite titles throughout the whole device. So you can have great experience using this processor. This processor also gives you great experience with brilliant picture quality along with smoother and longer gameplay. So again, it's a very good processor and it has massive 500 mAh battery, which ensures the extra power you need to break the barriers. It has Z-axis vibration motor equipped with an advanced linear motor that intelligently creates vibration effects matching your actions and offering. One of the most and important vital specification regarding this phone is the immersive sound experience. It has a very good sound quality because the dual speakers featuring higher volume and wider sound angle added some new experience in your gaming. Both the upper edge and the lower edge bottom of the phone contains the stereo speakers, which has very louder volume. So the phone has 13 megapixel front camera and 64 megapixel back camera with 8 megapixel of ultra wide lens, 2 megapixel of depth sensor and 2 megapixel of a macro camera. So now this is the bill. I brought it from Kolkata E-Mall, Bhanjalal Communications Private Limited. The net price was 15,000. Including GST tax. I brought it on the 6th of October 2021 this year. So this is the box where the details are mentioned. And coming to the camera quality, I don't find it very much useful for my vlogging because every time when I do the videos, I have to start focusing on the particular point on the screen. It is not like auto-focusing in my previous camera. Just like my previous camera used to auto-focus and auto-detect the faces and the objects I used to highlight in my video. And this feature is not here. I have to do it manually each and every time. And the picture quality is not so good. It's a bit blurry if I capture it from a distance. The night mode selfies are not so good. As well as the back camera pictures coming is not so very clear and prominent. So apart from the camera, the other things are okay. The price was 15,000. Redmi has upgraded their hardware processor as well as the camera resolution. Due to the presence of the dual stereo speakers, the sound is really very amazing and loud. for better quality of pictures, you can switch to 4:3 to click in the full resolution of 64 megapixels. Phone is very slim and light. It's not so weighty and there is a good battery life also. The thing is, which I feel should not be there, will be the notifications. There are lots of notifications. Even if you stop the notifications, camera is average. People who wants a very good quality camera within range 15,000 to 16,000 can go for it. But you can check the pictures which I have clicked here so that you can have an idea how good is the quality of picture and videos. The face quality of the picture which I clicked is kind of whitish tone. I took the 6GB 128GB variant with this particular deep sea blue color. I didn't get the call recording system available in this phone. During the conversation with somebody, I can't record anything. Apart from that, unnecessary promotional advertisement notifications are coming. Even there is a blockage of cookies and everything. So this is the overall review. Overall, it's a very good phone.